This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video.
Bounty Hunter, I have an assignment for you. There's a Jedi in the area who survived Order 66. Eliminate him.
As you wish.
Guys, we are doing another Star Wars video. Oh, how I love Star Wars. Maybe I should convince Jordy to do a Star Wars short film. What do you guys think? But anyways, I'm Janik for Cinecom.net and welcome to another Copycat Friday. And today we are having a look at the new Star Wars series called The Mandalorian. I've been waiting for this series for quite a while and have some high expectations for it. So let's hope they don't screw it up like, for example, Game of Thrones. But that aside, today we are recreating a typical weapon from Star Wars. And no, it's not the cool lightsaber of the Jedi or the Sith Lords, but the laser blaster that everyone else uses in the Star Wars universe. However, this would be the second time that we would mention a lightsaber in our video and not show you guys how to recreate them. So to avoid the dark side, let me just do a super quick mini tutorial about it. The first thing you need is the free Saber plugin of Video Copilot. Then inside After Effects, you just place your Jedi shot into a composition. Next, add the solid layer on top of the Jedi clip and drag the Saber plugin to the solid layer. After this, you will already have a Saber line on a black background. So you can set the blending mode of the Saber layer to add and remove the black. Now for the shape of the lightsaber, you can pick whatever preset you want. Personally, I really like the hardcore preset, because this will add more depth to the saber. Then the last thing you need to do is set the core start and end on the right spot. And of course, animate them if you move your saber around like an R shot. This will already leave you with a cool saber effect, but we can go much more advanced if you like. If you want to see that, give this video 10,000 likes and we will make it. And now that we have that out of the way, we can do a Janik's Fun Fact Fountain! Did you know that The Mandalorian has one of the biggest budgets for a TV series? They have a budget for over $100 million. Do you know what you can buy for that kind of money? That's about 500,000 custom lightsabers from the website Saberforge. I could start my own Jedi army. Or maybe a Sith army. But you can also plant 100 million trees with that kind of money. Because, team trees. Now to continue with the actual effect of today, the laser blaster. For this effect, you don't really need to do something special. Just film your bounty hunter shooting like crazy at his target. One thing I do like to mention, and that's recoil. After Jill told me that the laser blasters didn't have recoil, I didn't believe him. However, after doing some research, he was right. Jill overclassed me in being a Star Wars nerd. But what I do know is that the fact about stormtroopers being a terrible shot is quite incorrect. In fact, they are probably one of the best foot soldiers in the galaxy. When Order 66 was announced, they managed to slay multiple Jedis, and throughout the history of Star Wars, they also managed to beat the rebels over and over. And this is not something you can do by being a bad shot. But now that we have our shot, we can continue with creating the effect. And of course we are working with After Effects today, as this will make everything so much easier. And if you really want to make it yourself easy, you can use the Saber plugin of Video Copilot to create every laser beam you shoot. The principle is quite the same as with the lightsaber, but here you just need to animate them off screen. However, this is not the technique that we are going to use. We will create every blast from scratch. And you start this by placing your shooting shot into a composition. For the next step, you can create a white solid layer above the shooting shot. Now from this white solid, we are going to create our laser blast. To start, set the opacity to 50% so you can see the underlying clip. Then go to the toolbar on top and take the pen tool for creating masks. At the barrel of your blaster, you can now create a laser-shaped mask. Try to hold the perspective of the laser into account. In our shot, this means that the laser will be smaller at the gun and bigger at the side where it's going to. This is because the laser is moving to the screen. If it would move away from the screen, the perspective would be different, of course. Next, you can enable the animation for the mask pad and go about 12 frames further in time. Then move the mask off the screen and also adjust the mask so that it looks like the laser blast is becoming bigger as it's coming towards us. Once you have done this, set the opacity back to 100 and you can also feather the mask. At the beginning, set the feather to around 5. Again, enable the animation for the feather and at the end, set it to around 30. Okay, now you already have a white laser shooting out of your blaster. But let's make it the iconic red. Again, create a new solid layer, but this time make it red and place it underneath the white solid. To begin, you can change the blending mode of the white solid to add. Then copy the mask of the white solid and paste that to the red solid. When doing this, make sure that you are standing in the beginning of your timeline. Otherwise, your keyframes won't match. Of course, you can select the keyframes and drag them in the right spot, but this will cost you a few seconds. Once you have pasted the mask, it's time to adjust the feather. For the mask of the red solid, you can set the begin feather to around 15, and for the end feather, you can set it to around 130. Now you will already have a nice red glow, but let's add a little bit more. So duplicate the red solid underneath everything and again adjust the feather. You can leave the begin keyframe the same, but move the end keyframe to the middle of the layer and set this to around 200. This already looks a lot better. However, you can keep tweaking the laser by adding more glow if you want. You can even lower the opacity of the white solid so that it becomes more red. You can really customize the laser to your likings. Even the color. To do this, select the red solid layer and go up to the layer menu. Here you can click on the solid settings options, which will open a new pop-up window. Choose your new color and boom, your laser is green. But because our bounty hunter is quite evil, we are going to stick with the red color.
Zeg Jedi! Was het geen toen, mijn man?
Gewoon even een donkere kant, zeker?
Ja.
Hier in de lichte kant gebruiken we Storyblocks.
Storyblocks? En kan ik daar ook vlaaien mee bakken?
Nee, jongen. Het is een online bibliotheek.
Een bibliotheek?
Zeg maar zeker.
En wat kan ik dan daar zo allemaal in vinden, zo?
Hier, ze. After Effects templates.
Oh, jong. Dus ik kan daar gewoon mijn eigen logo in steken, of wat?
En nog veel meer. Compleet customizable.
Amai. En wat kan ik zo nog allemaal daarin terugvinden? Zo?
Oh, Ise. Lens flares.
Oh ja.
Transitions.
Oh, dat is juist.
Texteffecten.
Zijn dat hier achtergronden?
Zijn maar zeker.
Allee,
en nog veel meer. Alles wat je wilt.
Amai, dat vind ik wel heel ferm, ze. Maar, niet in 4K, ze, mijn man.
In HD en in 4K.
En in 4K?
Zijn maar zeker.
Amai. Voor de mensen thuis, 4K, dat betekent 4000.
Heel veel.
Heel veel dus, ja.
Heel erg veel.
Ja, ver, maar een arme stormtrooper kan dat niet betalen. Ze
dat wijs ik niet.
Hoe?
Je moet maar één keer per jaar betalen, het is niet duur. En je kunt ongelimiteerd downloaden.
Dat meent je niet, jongen.
Zeg maar zeker.
Allee, man. Ja, dat vind ik ver. En waar kan ik dat krijgen zo?
Ja, heel simpel. www.storyblocks.com/Cinecom, of ga gewoon naar de eerste link in dat boxje hier beneden.
Ah ja, maar dan ga ik daar meteen op klikken, man.
Gewoon doen.
Goh, dat is wel heel fijn. Weet je wat, om te vieren, we gaan perenvlaai eten, man. Ik heb er juist vers geplukt.
Ja, ik kom er straks aan. Dag, hè.
Now to keep our workflow clean, we are going to pre-comp all the solids of the laser and move all attributes into a new composition. This will combine all the solids in one layer, which is much cleaner. The next thing you can do now is set the blending mode of the pre-comp layer to add. Okay, we already have the basic laser, so now we can start by adding the details. First, let's add motion blur to the laser, and this you can easily do by adding the effect force motion blur. Now I find the shutter angle of 180 a little bit too much, so let's reduce that to 90. This will give us a nice subtle motion blur. The next step I want to explain to you guys is the light casted on your shooter by the laser. For this effect, you need to duplicate the original layer of the shooter. And with this layer selected, you can now mask out his head and stomach separately. These are the body parts that are going to catch the light from the blaster. And of course, you also need to feather the mask of those. Once they are masked out, you can now add the curse effect to the duplicate layer. Then within the effects, you can now set the channel to red and in the grid, drag the red line up. This will make your shot more red, However, not more bright. And it should be more bright, because the blaster lights it up. To fix this, you can also add the lumetri effect to the duplicate layer and increase the exposure a little bit, along with the highlights and the whites. Now, because the laser blast is just a quick flash, this extra light on your actor also needs to be a quick flash. So look for the point where your actor just shoots. Here you can enable the animation for the opacity and set it to 0. Here you can go one frame further in time and set the opacity to around 50. Again, go further in time and set it to 0. This will leave you with a short light flash on your body while you shoot. And if I must say, it already looks cool. But you can still add some small details to really finish it. Like a muzzle flash, which is crucial when shooting a gun. I also changed the color of the flash to something more red. This you can easily do by adding the tint effect to the muzzle layer. Inside the effect, you can now change the map white option to a light red color, and this will leave you with a matching muzzle flash. The last thing you can now do is maybe add a small lens flare to the barrel to really sell it. And of course, don't forget to add that iconic laser blaster sound from Star Wars. After this, you're finished. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, because we really enjoyed making it. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Oh, Leon. Hey Jedi, was it jij en toen jong?